Dodge up to touch the sky and landed on planet Uranus. Houston, we got a problem. No need to look.
We're at the home of the Super Bowl 52 champions, Lincoln Financial Field in Philadelphia, PA. Coming up, well, we've got what can only be described as a mirror image matchup, as it'll be the Philadelphia Eagles and themselves. Here's the kicker, Jake Elliott, ready to get this one started. And off we go from Lincoln Financial Field. And they will wrangle him down a couple yards shy of the 30. Swift to start the drive. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3.
That run right there was an offensive line coach's dream, wasn't it? Guys picked up all of their assignments, created a nice gap for the running back to get through, pick up 7 yards. Yeah, he's probably chortling on the headset right now saying, we got it going, boys, let's keep it going.
Here's 2nd and 3. This one out quickly to Watkins. 4 yards the pickup, first down.
A gain of 4 yards. And the Eagles, first down. First and 10 at the 40-yard line.
Now a give, right side Swift. And he'll be out of bounds, just shy of the 40. A big pickup there for the Eagles, first down, 18 yards. That O-line, they cleared a big hole there on that run.
The athleticism of offensive lines continues to evolve, and we're seeing it here. Not only are they controlling things right at the line of scrimmage, but they're able to get upfield to get to what we call the 2nd and 3rd levels. You know, get to the linebacker spot, the secondary spot, getting all the way downfield with their blocking, which helps keep the running back clean.
We're trying to continue that trend here this afternoon. Back-to-back nice gains, that one for 14 yards and another first. That early game script that they drew up is working pretty well here on this first drive, already in field goal range, Charles, knocking on the door of the red zone.
You know, Brandon, when we met with the coaching staff, they kind of predicted that they would come out firing like this. I think you and I were a little skeptical it would be this easy, but they certainly knew what they were doing in scouting, in preparation, and understanding what their team was capable of.
So the ball down to the 16 here for 1st and 10. They will run straight ahead with Swift. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. Sidney Brown in on the tackle.
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a gain considering the blitz that they just had against them.
No score after one on EA Sports. Now 2nd and 5. Swift going to try up the middle. And he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line. It'll only be a gain of 1 yard, and it sets up a 3rd down and 4 now. In search of 4 yards here to pick up the first down. Here's a handoff to Swift running left. And he'll take it into the end zone. DeAndre Swift, a 10-yard touchdown run. And the Eagles post the first points of the ball game as they take the lead here in this second quarter. They'll try to run with Swift. And he will get in to make it 8-0. Opening drive touchdown, and 2-point conversion.
Amazing nowadays for the kickers. I've actually talked with a few of them. They're more concerned about the point after touchdown than actually missing regular field goals. So maybe the coach is taking some pressure off here and just going for 2 and saying, I'm saving you for the big stuff later.
He's hanging out by the net. And he'll be brought down yards shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one. Hurts and the Eagles come up here first and 10 at their own 18. They'll start out here with the option left. And holding it may be the wrong decision as he stopped in the backfield. Josh Sweat coming in strong and dropping him behind the line of scrimmage. But sometimes that option can get bogged down before the gears really even get into motion. And I think that's what we saw there.
And I think what he saw defensive end right in his face because he looked up and he was right there. Didn't even have a chance to get going.
Now this one complete downfield on the left side. 14 yards there and an Eagle first down.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
From the gun, here's Swift. And this is going to be an Eagles first down as the tackle made just shy of the 40. All right, I got to ask you, with these RPOs, essentially the quarterback has three options, right? So what's different from that versus the triple option that we see the service academies run at the college level?
As a general rule, the triple option at the college level, most things are called outside of the quarterback faking it to the runner and then keeping it himself and maybe having a trail back. What I mean is, in the NFL, that option to throw the football all comes about organically. It's a natural deal based on reads. In college, if you're going to throw the football off a triple option, you've actually called that play.
From the 42-yard line, here's second down and 7. Hurts. Throwing over the middle, and it's incomplete.
In this case, no one came up with it.
On third down, a drop to throw. Airing it out deep for Smith. And that will be incomplete. That's scared of the midfield. That falls to the ground and brings up fourth down. On fourth down, punt coming from Braden Mann. And he gets it away. A directional kick going toward the sideline. And the punt over the side in the air. The spot will be inside the 35. Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. Just two series in here, Charles, but everything's gone to script so far. They got a touchdown on their first drive. Their defense holds, and now they've got a chance to take a two-score lead.
And to co-sign with you, exactly the start they scripted up. And really, that kind of start, that can set the tone for the game for them.
Now Hurts going to move them around. They just do get the playoff as he'll look to throw. Trying for Brown, and it's intercepted. Keely Ringo picks it off. And the Eagles are going to have it here just past the 25. So a nice play defensively by the rookie coming up with the INT.
And that's a late-round pick right there, making a first-round impact. And a lot of these day-three corners end up winding up on special teams and sub-packages and even on the practice squad. But he's really made an impact on this defense, and he comes up with the interception there.
And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. That's a good way to start the drive. 17 yards and a first down.
Partner, if you want more carries, I think we saw how you get him. Showed that he's got the fresh legs, and he picked up the first down on that run. Don't just ask for him. Show him that you're supposed to get the football.
And they'll go right back to Gainwell here on first down. And across the midfield stripe into Eagle territory. The Eagles going to take the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 45 seconds to go in the first half. Now second and 3. And they'll stay on the ground with Gainwell again. And he's going to be stopped up at about the 47-yard line.
Let's go, Eagles! Watching him complete it. behind you. He did that very well.
You praised him on tape yesterday for the angles that he takes to the ball. Took a great angle right there. Here comes third and the length of the football. He finds his man complete. That's Watkins. And he is out of bounds inside the 35. He's got his first catch here before halftime, and it goes for a first down. That time the conversion comes courtesy of the RPO.
And know what it did? It moved the sticks. Nice pickup on third down. Even better decision.
From the 34 now, here's first and 10. He'll look to throw. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete.
They decided the opportunity was there and launched a deep ball, but he was unable to get away from the defender, couldn't create space, couldn't uncover at the end of the route, and that one winds up incomplete.
Handoff. This is Swift. Now whistles and a timeout with 3 seconds left in the first half. So 3 seconds here remain in the half. On is the field goal unit to see about getting 3 points. From the right hash, this from 44 yards out. The kick by Elliott is good, and that will do it for this first half. First half in the books. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth, ready for quarter number 3. It's the Eagles ready to see the football first, and they trail here as we resume action in this third quarter. And they've got it up past the 35, so pretty good starting field position. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive.
Charles, it'll be interesting to see what adjustments this offense made in the locker room. Haven't really been able to get anything going offensively, virtually nothing in the ground attack either. So certainly something has to change here in quarter 3.
And I'm pretty sure their friends from the defensive side of the ball told them exactly that, because those guys, the stop troops, they've been playing pretty well. They've kept them around in this game. Now they've got some time. The running game struggled in the first half. Opposition knows how to focus on defending the pass here. They've got to re-energize that ground game and maybe open things up for a comeback here in this half.
On first and 10, it's Gainwell. And he'll manage to pick up about 4. It's second down.
Not a run that you're going to write home about, but still a good first down run. That's what an offense calls staying on schedule. 3 to 4 yards on first down, you're set up very well for the rest of the drive.
Off the play fake. Here's Hurts. This will be caught by Brown. And he has another first down as they'll get the ball down to the Eagles 23. A very solid gain of 27. Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move. First and 10. Yardage back to the 29. He lost 6 there on the first down play.
Well, we saw a lot of negative plays that resulted in plenty of lost yardage in the first half, and that trend is continuing here.
Tough spot looking at 2nd and 16 here after the big loss. Looking right side, and that's complete to Watkins. And down inside. inside the 15 he goes.
Yeah, you only get a one-yard buffer there from the line of scrimmage, and he got downfield a little too far, and the flag came out. Smith in motion right. He'll get it here on the jet sweep. And that is well read there defensively. He was looking to use his speed to get the edge, but they said no way. Just a 1 yard loss that time, but that's not what they needed. They're dealing with a third and long. Throwing is Hurts.
A bullet throw, but incomplete. Also, not getting a lot of help out there either.
Yeah, you nailed it pretty well, you know. He's got to throw it better, got to get more help. Obviously, one that should have been caught, they've got to find a way to bring those two elements together so they can make some progress in this one.
So they were facing the deficit coming out of the locker room at intermission, and at least they're able to get the field goal to cut into that deficit.
Yeah, now your offense feels pretty good about itself, right? A little bit more up to speed coming out of the break. You turn to your defense now and say, hey, we got three there. We're chipping into the lead. Can you help us out? Hold them. Let's get the ball back for us.
Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go.
Now this game, it has obviously been all about the defense on both sides of the football. Which offense is going to break through here? We'll see if they can do it on this drive.
And they'll get eight out of this before being stopped at the 28. Line of scrimmage, the 28 now as they come up on second and a couple. Here's a handoff to Swift. And only able to get two here, stopped at the 30.
Ladies and gentlemen, that is a force of nature in the defensive tackle position. Yes, he's as big as they come, but still plenty agile. He's able to make a nice play there to swallow up the ball carrier.
And this is going to be an Eagles first down as the tackle made at the 35-yard line.
Touchdown. Here's Elliott on to kick it away.
From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end.
Now a hit and a loose football.
And it looks like one of the DBs has it.
So they will set up shop. Excellent field position in the red zone at the 19-yard line.
So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20.
Now it's Swift. And he'll take it from the 18 to the 15, a gain of three.
Brandon, you know how many times we've done games, and at the start of the fourth quarter, we see both teams hold up the four fingers, fourth quarter is ours. Well, how about this drive? You saw the four fingers for four-minute offense. And this offensive line has really hunkered down and established themselves.
And this is where they say, put the game on our shoulders, we'll lead the way, right?
No doubt about it. And let me tell you, if you're a running back, all you want to do is get behind those big fellas, have a little vision, and find some space.
And a solid way to do that on the first play of the drive there. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down. 2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. Two of their three red zone trips so far, they've come up empty on. They'll look to reverse that trend on second and goal.
Hurts with a quick throw, complete.
5 yards that time on the completion, and now it's third and goal.
run with Swift.
And he is into the end zone. Touchdown.
DeAndre Swift.
His second touchdown of the afternoon.
And the Eagles have extended their lead to 15 now here in the fourth. They'll try to run with Swift.
And he is into the end zone again as he scores both the touchdown and the two-point conversion to extend this lead. Touchdown. Here's Elliott on to kick it away. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. Well, probably not much that they can do at this point, CD. Down three scores late in the fourth quarter. This is going to be a little too much to overcome, you would think.
Yeah, they'll go down swinging, but in the end, I think we saw the writing on the wall a while back because one team was clearly better than the other in this one. And while it didn't quite reach blowout status, I think we knew who was going to win this one well before we got to this stage.
Play action. Here's Hurts.
Now a desperation throw deep downfield. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
That's coverage you'd expect to see in a tie game late. Not in a lopsided game like this. They are not letting up.
Second and five.
He'll look to throw. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete.
Defensively, they're stacking them in. One incompletion, two incompletion. They're going for more.
They come up now, third and five, following the incomplete pass. He'll drop to throw.
Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete.
The Eagles going to take the first of their timeouts as they get it with under a minute to go now in the football game.
They go play action with Hurts. Oh, that's into double coverage. It enters.
Oh, they try lateral on the return, and now the ball's loose. And it's picked up by the Eagles. And I don't know that that fumble's going to matter a whole lot. You look at the deficit here in the fourth. It doesn't matter. The coach on the sideline still scratching his head.
Yeah, not only scratching his head, but probably writing a note or two about, we're going to address this come practice next week because maybe that's the reason we're down this far. Doesn't matter at this point. But being sloppy throughout the game, not going to help him improve.
97 yards on the ground here for Swift. He's got a first down as well. No doubt those are the types of carries they're looking for here, Charles. The lead in the fourth quarter. This is when coaches that have a reliable running game, they breathe a little easier on the sideline.
Yeah, they love the idea that they can take the air out of the football at this point of the game. That means they're really counting on that offensive line, counting on the runners, taking care of the football. Because you're going to tell your quarterback, hey, no time to be a hero. We're going to play you. Just eat up that clock. And if you have the ball, they can't score.
Well, CD, for the losing side, they had opportunities in this one, but big plays just didn't go their way, especially late. And they have to suffer the L here.
So it felt like that takeaway, once it happened, and after.